I've asked you to come together to assist me with an appeal to the public in regards to the death of a four-month-old child at Bundaberg last week. At about 5 p.m. on the 26th of February, police were called. Police were notified about an incident. Can we start again, or
just from the
At about 5 p.m. on Monday, the 26th of February, police were made aware of an incident that had occurred at Electra Street, Bundaberg, where a four-month-old child had received injuries and was transported to the Budrum Hospital. As a result of the injuries suffered by that four-month-old child, that child has died on Sunday. So police are conducting an investigation around the circumstances of the death of that child. At this point, there are a number of issues around the injuries to that child that are unexplained. So police are making an appeal to the Bundaberg community and others to establish if there's any information that would assist the investigators in relation to the death of that child. Any questions?
What kind of injuries did the baby suffer?
The post-mortem has not been conducted at this stage, so we'll know that later in the week.
How were police notified? Was it family?
So the child was transported to the Budrum, the child was transported to the Bundaberg Hospital, and the hospital has advised our Child Protection Investigation Unit officers.
Are the family known to Child Protective Services?
No.
Do the family have any other children in their care?
No.
Was the family involved, like a mum and dad, or was the baby in their care?
We're trying to establish those circumstances. So we're wanting to hear from the community about any information in relation to the movements of this child and this couple on the 26th day of February.
When you say movements, do you mean where they were about town? Or
So when I say movements, movements throughout the city of Bundaberg.
Were the family not known to Child Protective Services, but were they known to police at all?
No, not necessarily, no.
Do we know how old the baby's parents are?
They're young people.
So like under the 25?
Yes. Yep, they're young people.
Are they teenagers?
Yes.
And outside of the appeal, what's your message, if any, to the public about this incident?
Well, obviously, we have vulnerable people in the community that are in need of assistance and care at times, and we would just ask that those vulnerable people in our community are getting every care and attention that they need. And this is a particularly delicate and sad incident, obviously because of the vulnerable nature of this child.
Aside from injuries, were there any other signs of abuse or neglect?
No.
Were the baby's parents mechanics?
No.
Were they still at school?
No.
Are you asking about any incident that may have happened prior or in and around that area?
So any information around the movements of this couple and their child. We understand at this stage that the couple and the child have moved around town on the day in question. So we're wanting to hear from any members of the community or associates about the movements or any activities around that couple and the deceased child.
Have the couple provided a version to police of what they say happened?
Police are currently dealing with the couple, but as you can imagine, this is a very distressing incident for the couple. So we are dealing with them and we are moving through the investigation as best we can.
So they are assisting police?
Yes.
What sort of injuries did the child present to the hospital with, or what sort of state were they in?
I can't really comment on that. We haven't got definitive medical advice as yet. Obviously, the post-mortem hasn't been conducted, so I can't really comment on that.
And just to clarify, they presented to the Bundaberg Hospital, not the Budrum?
Yes.
Great.
And are the parents from Bundy originally or from somewhere else?
That's more than I can tell you. I haven't dove into that pattern of life inquiry.
What will the next stages of the investigation look like for police?
Well, we will have a post-mortem conducted later in the week, and we will hear from the pathologist around the mechanism of injury around the death of the child. Any other questions?
I'm okay.
Obviously, parenting can be pretty hard. There are avenues out there for people to seek assistance if they're having trouble with kids or anything like that. Do you want to take that approach?
No, there probably is, but I couldn't really comment on it.
Yep.
We have a number of non-government agencies in town that are doing work in that space.
Okay.
Anything else you'd like to add?
No. Generally, we're just after that information around the movements of the couple and their child at this point. We've conducted other inquiries, we've hit some dead ends, so we're just looking for some community information around this matter.
What have those inquiries been that have been dead ends?
The likes of door knocks and CCTV.
What sort of information is it like, do you guys find useful, like CCTV, just any like indication of an incident happened at such and such a place?
Yeah.
Even if it is that couple or whatnot, whether or not, you know?
Yeah, so we're trying to understand the mechanism of the injury to this child. So if there is information out there in the broader community, we'd like to hear if there is a reason why this child has died that could be explained.
Do you think that there are people out in the community who have information that police need?
Yes, certainly. We expect that there is someone out there in the Bundaberg community that can assist this investigation.
Is there anything specific that the public should be, if they've seen, to report to police?
No, not particularly. Just an incident around that child.
Is there any particular things in the community that this family were involved in that might trigger, you know, someone in that same community?
No.
It's not like a car or a vehicle or anything like that?
No.